Alrighty, well, good evening, everybody, and, well, I thought I'd go ahead and do, once again, what I did a few weeks ago, go ahead and do a Vampire Survivors run. Now, I don't know exactly which stage I'm gonna be playing in. I'll probably figure that out when I actually get into the game, but, most certainly I'll be playing with Poe. He's the one with the garlic and the, extra pickup range. So I'll most likely be going in with him. And again, the stage I'll be running with will be random, but it's just something I felt like doing. So, and then usually I'll have normally, or let me rephrase that. Last time I did it, I just had the in-game music on it, but it just got pretty annoying. It's just a bunch of, you know, just 180 beats per minute, you know, kind of like EDM, electronic dance music. Although in this here, it has some chiptune thrown in, so wasn't really into it. But to be fair, what I'm about to play in the game is probably very not appropriate to this kind of game, but it is what I'm into right now. But it's pretty obvious, the Toad Folk, the band, I guess if you want to call it that, is Tales Under the Yoke. They've actually done a few of these other albums over the months or years, like the Toad Shaman, the Toad King, stuff like that. So yeah, once again, probably not the most appropriate for this kind of game, but the in-game stuff, I'm not really into. So, but otherwise, just I hope you enjoy.
one of the first projects that he mastered all by himself after finishing the carvings in the cathedral. He was then noticed, and after 5 years of honest hard work, he was invited to plan a project at the Royal Castle together with a few more famous carvers from the far swamps. It is hard to describe the huge honor it was for him. And as he saw his name, Grog the Builder, woven with a golden thread amongst others on the huge royal carpet decorating the main castle hall, he gazed with a clear thought. This is it. This is the biggest creation of my life. It was surprising that insignificant old creation in front of him slowly vanishing. It was an ordinary house for a simple toad family, but it was where everything started. Well, muttered Grog the Builder to himself, waking up from his own thoughts. This family needs a new home anyway, and I will do my best to create the most beautiful thing in a simple way I've ever made before.
Thank you.
Rustling in the thick swamp bushes got attention for the little toad, playing with his friend in the midsummer evening. Hush, what was that? I didn't hear anything. Could be fish or just a breeze. No. There is surely something bigger than a fish, and it moves above the water. Frowning toad was sitting on that boat, made of a dried, oiled water lily, with two big sacks on each side. Focused on his own thoughts, he did not smile. Yet the children could see that he was a friendly creature. "Good evening, little folks," said the boat toad, and coughed. "I hope I did not disturb your peaceful evening. I am just passing by to see if the south corner of the swamp already has something to offer." "What is it the swamp can offer you?" asked one of the little toads, undisguised interest. "The vines and berries in all the kingdom, of course. Now, have a good evening, little ones. I've got some time to waste." With these words, he made two strong pushes with his beautiful, lightweight paddle and disappeared behind the low willow branches.
"Who was that?"
asked the youngest toad.
"That was old Bob, the berry belly," said the other one proudly. "My granny told me stories about him and his craft. He doesn't have to come to me, but as far as I know, every cure potion we've got in winter is made out of these rare berries he finds. Oh, it is getting late. Let's get back home before everyone starts to worry about us." "I want to be a boat toad too when I grow up," cried the youngest toad, inspired, catching up with his friend up the hill. Thank you.
Was a harp. A beautiful melody resonated in the bow's wood, and the fairy bug started to swing slowly.